the channel. In the last video of this series, we introduced Mockito. And Mockito is an open source test automation framework that internally uses Java Reflections API to create mock objects. Today we will expand further on this topic and try to tackle new Mockito functionalities. So please, if you haven't watched our part 1 video or have no idea what Mockito is, I recommend you take a look at the video linked in the card above before proceeding with this one. Okay, I am going to start with the verify method. We briefly mentioned it in the last video while verifying a simple invocation on a mock, similarly to the example you see. But verify has multiple other use cases. In addition to checking the invocation to the method itself, you can check the number of invocations by making use of the times method. A never method also exists. You can make use of this one instead of writing times 0, it ensures that the method of this mock was never called. You can also verify that no interactions occurred with the mock as a whole and not only a specific method by making use of the verify no interactions method. Now, what if you need the times method but don't have the exact number of interactions? So you know that this mock will be called at least 3 times, but not exactly 3 times. How do you verify this? Well, you'll be happy to hear that there exists at least and at most methods as well. These methods do exactly what we just explained. Okay, let's take this piece of code now. You see here we assert or verify that the add method was called once. However, what we want to make sure of as well is that no more interactions are done with this mock after this element is added. We want to make sure that nothing is happening after that invocation. And to do that, we can make use of the verify no more interactions method, as you can see. Okay, before switching to the arguments part of the verify method, the last check you can do is verify the order of interactions by making use of Mockito's inOrder class. This class is provided with the mocked object and then a series of verify calls. It then asserts that these calls are being called in that exact order. If we go ahead and flip one of the methods or try to change that order, our test will fail. Okay, this next part was kind of discussed in the last video, so I'll go over it briefly. You see, while verifying an invocation, you can either pass the exact argument to the verify method and it will verify that this exact argument was used as well, or you can choose Mockito's flexible arguments or argument matchers by making use of any string, any list, etc. based on your argument type. Note that any does not only store all types of objects, but also the null value. The others cannot infer null. Finally, one last option, you can pass in an argument captor to capture the argument passed and perform extra assertions on it, similarly to what we previously covered. Okay, now for the second part of the video, we are going to tackle void methods. You see, all the stubs we created so far in this series have been for methods that return values, but never void methods. Why is that? What is so special about them? Let's dive right into it. Void methods can be used with Mockito's doNothing, doThrow, and doAnswer methods. Do nothing is Mockito's default behavior for void methods. The two tests you see have the same behavior. One reason to override the default behavior with do nothing is to capture arguments. In the example you see, we used the verify method to check the arguments passed to the add method. Concerning do throw, when used, it will throw the provided exception similarly to the then throw method, but this one is reserved for methods with no return types or void. Now, a method may perform more complex behaviors than merely adding or setting value. For these situations, we can use Mockito's doAnswer method to add the behavior we need. In this example, we verified that the arguments passed to the method we have are indeed the ones we are looking for without making use of argument captors. Finally, partial mocks are an option too. Mockito's doCallReal method can be used on void methods. This way, we can call the actual method and verify it at the same time. In the example you see, the real behavior implemented inside some method will be called. Okay, few minutes ago I hinted at something called argument matcher, which is when you make use of the anyString method, for example. And there are a couple of things I want to tell you about these matchers before ending the video. You see, matchers cannot be used as return values, cannot be used outside of verification or stubbing, and cannot be used alongside exact values. Let me expand on the last one. Suppose we have this test. The method we are using takes in an integer and a string. Now, I don't really care what string I am passing to the method, but I need the integer to be exactly equal to 5. If the stub is written like the one you see, Mockito will throw an exception saying that two argument matchers were expected, whereas only one was provided. To fix this, what we need to do here is use the EQ matcher alongside the anyString matcher. After doing this, the test will pass as expected. So, if you make use of matchers in one of the arguments, then you'll have to do the same for the rest. Feel free to play around matchers, there's a ton of them ranging from the AND, OR, null checks, and many other functionalities. And the best part about matchers is that on top of all of this, you have the ability to create your own custom matchers. To do that, you implement the argument matcher interface and fill the logic you want inside the matches method. To use the created matcher, we need to modify our test to use the argThat method. Keep in mind that argument matchers are different than argument captors and shouldn't be confused for them. You see, both techniques can be used to make sure certain arguments are passed to mocks. However, captors may be a better fit if we need to assert on argument values or if our custom argument matcher isn't likely to be reused. On the other hand, matchers are usually better for stubbing, as creating your own matchers will allow you to select the best possible approach for a given scenario and produce high-quality tests that are clean and maintainable. Let me know in the comments below if you'd like a part 3 video for this series. And until then, that's it for this video. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.